They say there are two ways to win elections, promise hope or predict doom. The Prime Minister of the Czech Republic believes in the latter. He is predicting doom, the end of a homogeneous Christian Europe. We are talking about this man, Andrej Babiš. He's been the Prime Minister of the Czech Republic since 2017, a billionaire turned politician and no stranger to controversy. The Forbes magazine once called him the Czech Trump. But does he measure up to the real Donald? Well, the outlandish predictions are certainly there. A few days back, Prime Minister Babiš wrote an opinion piece on Europe's immigration policy. At least, that was the intention. The article soon veered towards Islamophobia. It ended with two predictions. The Netherlands will become a Muslim-majority nation by 2044, and Sweden will meet the same fate in 2065. So two quintessential European countries becoming Muslim nations. Does it sound unrealistic? It should, because it is. Here's how the population looks like in both these countries. 50% of the Dutch population do not believe in God. Christians make up 43%, Muslims 5%. What about Sweden? Half the country follows Christianity. 8% of Swedes are Muslims. The Czech Prime Minister is convinced that these numbers will explode. But demographers do not agree. This is what the Pew Research Institute found. Right now, 5% of Europe's population is Muslim. By 2050, this could reach 11%. In the case of Sweden, the Muslim population could reach anywhere between 11 to 30%. A sociologist at the Charles University in Prague says the Czech Prime Minister is completely wrong. He says Babiš is trying to scare people, and it wouldn't be a first for him. Last year, the Prime Minister had a similar prediction for Belgium. He said the country would have a Muslim majority by 2050. Again, a load of nonsense. So if the science does not add up, why is the Czech Prime Minister saying all of this? It's a classic case of fear-mongering, appealing to the worst tendencies of his people. The Czech Republic has traditionally opposed immigration. We saw this during the 2015 refugee crisis. The Czech government refused to accept the EU's migrant quota. Andrej Babiš was Deputy Prime Minister back then. Now he's back with the migrant rhetoric, right on time for another hateful campaign. Elections in the Czech Republic are scheduled for October this year. Babiš already heads a minority government, and he's resorted to Islamophobia to drum up support. By doing this, he has opened Pandora's box. He has given fodder to the neo-Nazis in Europe, two things that never end well. He has also set back Europe's campaign against extremism. Let me tell you how. Battling Islamist extremism is a delicate policy. The idea is to target the people, not the religion. That's the fine line between Islamophobia and anti-terrorism. Muslims in Europe already feel alienated. They feel the state is targeting them for their beliefs. And comments like these fuel those fears. They defeat outreach programs and build tensions between communities. Some European governments have understood this. France, for example, it has a robust policy to tackle extremism. But the government also embraces immigration and diversity. President Macron once said that France is not a fixed identity, it is always changing. But leaders like Babiš do not accept this. They are still holding on to Europe's colonial age. A white, Christian and racist Europe. They spread fear and panic. They make baseless predictions that Europe is becoming a Muslim continent. Not only are they wrong, they're setting off a movement they cannot control. Because when Europe goes right, there are no half measures. WeOn is now available in your country. Download the app now and get all the news on the move.